Hi guys, welcome back. I hope you all are doing great and I hope you all have been staying safe and healthy. I am making my first YouTube video for 2023 and today is like 31st of Jan, so I had to make one today. I have been making shorts and I mean I enjoy them a little bit, not as much as I enjoy making a full length YouTube video because I can't really communicate much in there. There's no personal touch, it's just to the point, so I kind of miss this. But unfortunately YouTube videos don't get that kind of reach that generally shorts get. If you compared the numbers on my channel alone, you would see what I mean. That is why I was so uninspired to make it, but I was like, you know what, irrespective of whether I'm getting views or not, I think I should do what makes me happy, and making full-length YouTube videos make me happy. So the weather is like suddenly hot again. It was so nice and cold for at least like 2-3 weeks, like the kind of cold I like, not the Delhi wala cold. Oh my god, I'm sure you guys know that Deb was getting married, so her wedding along with, so we had to go to Delhi. Her wedding happened in Delhi, and over there, like on the first day itself, the first day we chilled for a bit and we went off to sleep. The next day was the first event, which was the mehndi ceremony, and by the end of it, like we after the mehndi was the cocktail, so we had to get ready for the cocktail. Hold on, let me get my moisturizer so that I can start. I mean, I'm so stupid, I didn't even mention what I'm doing, so I'm gonna just do my makeup and we are gonna talk. So that's the whole video. Okay, so I'm going to be doing a full neutral glam get ready with me as I chat. So so after the mehndi event, everybody was like chilling and taking rest, getting ready for the cocktail. And I mean we ordered for something from Swiggy and I went downstairs to get it. Now, like this property was like inside, it was not like on the main road or something. And I was waiting for the Swiggy guy to come, and there was a dog. Okay, now this dog is a stray dog, but he was inside the property. The property had like a bed and everything for the dog. He didn't have a collar though, like, but he was the property's dog, and he was inside the lobby and he came towards me. I was standing near the lobby and he came. And I was like, okay, he seems to be friendly. Like, he's standing next to my leg and he's like, you know how they do that thing on your leg, right? They kind of put their head. I was like, okay, such a cute little fluffer. I started petting him, scratching his head, and he didn't growl or, you know, express any sort of discomfort with that. I was like, okay. And I had a glass of wine in my hand, okay? And then he went and he sat like in the corner. There was like a small area where they had like a small bed for him, and he went over there and he sat, and I was also, and the sofa is right next to that. So I had my phone in one hand and the wine glass in the other, and I went there, I kept my phone on the sofa. Okay, I was just standing, and mid-air, no, I did this kuchu-kuchu action. I didn't touch him. This bugger just flung and like he just bit me, like he just grabbed onto my hand and he didn't leave. Okay, like it's healed quite a bit. I can't even show you guys the wound. So like the fat from my hand also came out, you know, like this part, and it was like a big scene. I'm so happy that Ramesh, Debashree's husband, and his friends and all were very helpful. They took me to the hospital and everything. Imagine, you know, everybody's partying and suddenly you have to like go to the hospital with someone. I got a little upset with the receptionist because he was sitting over there and watching all of this. He could have told me, right, when the dog first came to me and I scratched him on the head, he could have told me that, ma'am, don't touch him, he can be a bit aggressive, ye wo. He didn't say anything. He just stood there and like he saw me pet the dog. He didn't say anything about it. Then had he told me that, you know, don't pet him, okay, you did it already, but don't pet him again, he can bite, I wouldn't have gone. And the funny bit is that exactly one year ago, I was in Darjeeling for another friend's wedding and a monkey bit me. So they did not have to give me like 7 injections since I had taken 5 already. And yeah, they gave me 2 shots. I came, one I took over there that same day itself, and the second one I came back and I took on Christmas. So that was the scene. The whole of Jan, how did it go for you guys? Mine was okay. It was not bad. It was not good. It was okay. I hope Feb is much better though. I done a poll a while back where you guys said that, you know, you were okay with like a long form video. Sorry about my phone. You guys were okay with long form content, but in the same category, like, do you just prefer me talking about makeup, skincare, or even vlogs work? Because I stopped vlogging. I had a separate channel for vlogging. I took down all the videos. I mean, they're all private now. I think I've rambled too much about like random stuff. So let me just focus a little bit on what I'm doing right now. So I did my whole skin prep, okay? And I'll have all the products listed down below. I bought another one of these Mars beauty blenders. This is amazing, guys. These are very, very cheap, like 100 and something, 45 rupees, and they are really good quality. You would once you buy this and you try it out, no, I don't think you will go and buy any other beauty blender. Like, I very rarely repurchase things because I always have something new to try, but this was really, really nice. I'm going to use my Maybelline Fit Me foundation. I really want to buy the face, the skin tints that they've just launched. I think this is a bit too light for me right now. I'm just gonna add a little bit of this darker NYX foundation. This is the old packaging. You know, when they did the PR for this, when NYX had launched in India and they did like a 2-year anniversary after being launched, for some reason they sent every shade in the range in the PR kit, okay? Every shade. I gave so many of them away to like makeup artist friends because it really doesn't make sense to just have all those shades in my collection, right? But I did keep like a couple of lighter colors, medium ones, and like a few darker shades, so that, you know, you can always customize a foundation tone if it's not fitting your skin tone right now. And you could always mix your foundation as well. I think it's still a bit too light, no? But TK will make it work. So what's been happening? I think I asked you like 5 times already. As if, you know, you will reply. What are you guys watching right now? Any show, movie recommendations? Let me know in the comments below. I always feel very sad to like mess up my new sponges, but you know. Oh, actually the shade matches my skin tone right out. I think it's blending into my skin. I don't know why there are like 10 planes flying every 2 seconds. Like, you heard one right now, right? Now I'll tell you when the next one is gonna come. One of the makeup trends this year is like dewy glass skin looks, and I've been doing that anyway before the whole year started, and I've been enjoying it because my skin's been doing really well. I do still test out skincare products, like new skincare brands and everything. So this one right here is by the brand OTT. It's their Do It All moisturizer. It has rose and niacinamide. It's a very nice thin moisturizer. I layer it on top of my squalene, but I have really dry skin right now in at this stage in my life. I used to have oily skin before, and it did gradually become combination, and right now it's dry. But as the season changes, it could change again, and I may have to kind of change the products that I see. Another plane. Change the products I use, but right now this has been working so well for my skin. I also made a couple of lifestyle changes, and if you want, I could do a separate video on all the little things that I've changed in my life. And I'll be honest with you guys, this is the happiest I have ever been. And like, you know, all like the last 4 years of my life was a bit challenging, a bit difficult. I was still exploring things about myself. I'm gonna conceal. I'm using my Too Faced concealer. I bought this amazing concealer, guys. Like, you have to try this. And this bottle is for like 3,000 something, but I'm telling you, this is going to last you for a very, very, very long time. It's like a, sometimes you, I just don't even use foundation. I just use this because I have dark circles a little bit and it's good enough. That's it. So I think that I've been the happiest lately. I basically stopped, I changed the way I think. I don't really think about things that have happened in the past because, you know what, one, you have no control over things that have already happened, okay? And you're thinking about something that's already gone and cribbing about it in your present, which is ruining your present, which is all you have. Honestly, the present is what you have. And the future is uncertain because it has not yet happened. And thinking too much about what will happen and worrying about it today is not gonna change anything. You will think about it the next day, the day after. Like, people usually live in the past or in the future. They keep thinking about their future, they keep worrying about things, and some people keep thinking about shit that's happened in the past and keep worrying about that. You know what? It's just try for a day as like a challenge, as an activity, you know, to not worry about things that you don't have any control over, like another plane there. Oh my god. Okay, so if you saw my reel on this blush, that was the first day I used it, first or second day, and see, it's been like whatever, a month and a half since I've been using it, and the rose shape has still, like, is still intact. Obviously you will see a little bit of smudging, but overall, I am pretty impressed. It might look like it's too much right now, but it's not. I will powder my face and it will settle down a little bit. I do personally like a little bit of extra blushy blush. It's just my personal preference, but if you like, you could like make it a little, keep it a little over here. I like to bring it all the way till this part. I was saying something and it got cut, and then I completely lost my train of thought. But if you guys want me to make a video, separate video on just this, I could. Let me know what you think. But yeah, I am so excited for life right now just because I have a very different outlook on things. I'm going to use my MAC Mineralized Skinfinish in Medium Plus and set my face. I decided that I'm not going to buy any makeup, but I bought this eyeshadow palette. I bought it. It is stunning. But I bought it only because I mean it was trending, and I thought, you know, if I did like a whole video swatch, blah, 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 people will watch it. But nobody watched it. It's okay. But you want to watch the swatches, you can watch it on my shorts, also on my Instagram. So I'm going to do a very naturalish look today. I will do more dramatic. You see my phone? That is to film a transition reel right after my makeup is done. Okay. I am so distracted today. Oh my god, I'm sweat. Another plane. I'm sweating. I need to find a better like setup in my room where the AC ka hawa comes to me. Right now I'm in this balcony studio. Do you like this setup? This is like the best place to get maximum natural lighting. You see, all of that is like a window, and behind me also is a window. Oh my god. So I'm going to do a very natural look. I'm going to use like these neutralish, pinky neutralish shades. I'm going to do like inner corner. Let's go about the video. I'm going to use Keep Going, which is this like toffee-ish brown shade. The formula of these eyeshadows are really nice. Huh? Like, if you have this and like another palette which has a little pinky rosy shades, you're sorted. Like, you don't need any other palette. See, like, I just pressed the brush against my eyelid. They blend out so easily and so quickly. Next, I'm going to go in with Bold Mousse, which is this beautiful neutral toned shimmery eyeshadow, and I'm going to place this towards my inner corners. I haven't blended it out yet. I've just placed it. I will blend it out in a bit. What is your signature makeup look? But you just do whatever you feel like doing. I remember mine would always be eyeliner, lipstick, mascara. okay, I'm going to take like a fluffier brush and blend out, try to blend it as gently as I can, because this is a very glittery eyeshadow. I'm just tapping it, not really swiping it around. Yep, that just worked. So a lot of people have asked me how I do my eyeliner, and I used to do it a certain way before, and after coming back from Delhi, I changed the way I do my liner. And thanks to Chirag and Sanjana, I'm gonna have both of their Instagram accounts linked down below. They are MAC makeup artists. They were there at the wedding and they were like the sweetest people. I mean, I had the best time with them. They were in our room, like my and Nikita's room, and they were doing everybody's makeup. And after I got bit and all, they were so nice to me. Chirag offered me to do my makeup. Sanjana did my makeup. They were very nice people and they used this technique and my eyeliner did not budge. Now, I have, you know, like a bump here on top of my lid, which you can't really see. But whenever I open my eyes, if I've done my liner, there's always like a tiny bit of liner that gets deposited on top after a while. And if my lids get, oh my God, it's plain. So it always gets transferred after a while and I have to like keep rubbing it. And the eyeshadow from this area ends up getting smudged all the time. And this technique has been working out really well for me. Although there are still times when, you know, if the weather is really humid, it will transfer. And I am trying to find a eyeshadow or a liquid liner formula that like not transfer, just sits on top of your lid. But until then, this is what I'm doing. So I'm going to take like a eyeliner, a kajal pencil that is smudgeable. This is the PAC gel eye pencil. And depending on how thick or thin you want your eyeliner to be, if you do go in directly with this, there is a chance that it can be a bit thicker. But if you want a very thin, precise line, use like a brush, take some of it on the brush and then just... So I'm going to take an eyeliner brush. This is my MAC 210 brush. You guys won't believe it. This was my first ever MAC brush that I purchased, okay? And it's been around 12 years and this brush is still just as good. So I like taking some of it on my brush if I want to do like a thinner line. Generally, I go with like a very nice thick line. Since I don't wear eyeshadow every single day on my eyelids, I just do the inner corners and liner. Hold on, let me get a mirror. And I'll just draw. It will not be opaque, okay? It's not going to be like jet black, and that's okay. We are just creating a base. And also, if you're a beginner at eyeliner, this technique might help you quite a bit because you have more control, you know, like where the eyeliner is getting placed. Unlike using a brush tip directly or a liquid where your hand can wobble, this gives you more control. Even gels do that, by the way. Also, I need to buy a new gel eyeliner. Any suggestions, recommendations? Let me know. Do you guys hear another plane? What is happening today? Like, why? I think every afternoon the plane ka frequency increases. I just make like a very faint line like that. Can you even see what I'm doing? Can you? Hold on, let me focus. Yeah, there. You see this scar? This is also a dog bite. Okay, so I just follow my lower lash line and create a wing like that. And I'm just gonna join that. And I'm just gonna fill in any little gaps that might be peeking through. This is what it looks like. It's not perfect right now. It obviously needs to be refined, but this is my base. This is the base to my eyeliner. I'm just gonna go and trace my eyeliner with a felt tip. This is the Too Faced Better Than Sex liner. You could use any, you know, any felt tip liner that has been working for you. Make sure you do this as carefully as possible. Don't want to go over the lines. And this is gonna be very easy to do since you already have your eye base done. Here's a before, this is just with the coal pencil, and this is after refining it with the felt tip liner. Okay, so I have my lashes done. I've used really natural looking thin lashes and my brows. I was looking for my nude coal pencil, but I cannot find it, so I'm just going to use the silver as a base. I was thinking, since I have little purple in my hair, I was thinking of doing like a purple of waterline. So I'm just going to line my waterline with this first. I just need like a base for something to stick onto. I had a purple liner somewhere but cannot find it. And then I'm just going to take this pack eyeshadow. This is PP38. I don't know if this is still available. I'm sure they have, like, it's a very pretty purple, you know. And I'm going to use a tiny brush like this one and stamp it on my waterline. Okay, it turned out pretty well. So let's do it. So if you wear lenses and do this, just be careful. The powder can get onto your lenses and blur your vision. So be careful with that. Use like a purple coal pencil directly. I cannot find mine and I don't have this exact color. The one that I have is like slightly darker. There you go. For highlighter, although my skin has like this natural glow, I'm going to use this one. This is by PAC. This is one of their newest launches, Focus on Me Blush and Highlighter. This is in the shade medium. So I'm just going to, and I've used this quite a bit. I use this in Delhi. I'm going to take a little bit and just, you know, stamp it. I'm not even going to like, this is like one of those fluffy brushes. Just don't want like that straight line. I just want it to look very blurred out. See? Such a natural glow. This won't look very stark even when someone sees me in person. So I'm not really sure what to do for my lips. So first I'm going to go in with this nude color. This is one of my favorites. This is Dolly Dark Pink from SIMPLYNAM. Really pretty neutral shade for, you know, most skin tones. It's almost the same color as my lip. Almost. Really nice formula. Do check it out if you guys are looking for a shade like this. Really good shade. Okay, so I really love these. This is the Colorbar gel lip colors. Now pretty much all the colors in this range will, it's a lip tint. Okay, it gives you either like that whole glossy dark lip look if you go really in with it, or you get like a really nice sheer tint. I have a couple of shades from here. So this particular one is called Cheeky. It's a very pretty purple. Okay, it's a very dark purple, and it is a, the formula is pretty intense. Like one dot of this and it'll stay in your skin. Okay, like look at that. I've applied it, and if I rub it off completely, you can see that the stain is still there. And if you leave it on for a few more seconds and then rub it off, that stain doesn't even move. Like for example, on my finger, I rubbed it off and you can see the stain. So I was thinking I'll just add a couple of dots in and quickly blend it. What do you guys think? It looks red, no? But it's actually like a dark purple. Okay, so that makes it look like that, like a little glossy. And this is gonna stain my lips, okay? It's gonna stay like that for a very long time. I did a little bit of a outfit change. I wore a necklace for the first time. I mean, I don't usually wear anything in my neck. I'm just so weirded out. I got this from Accessorize. It was on sale, so I picked it up. It's very cute. It covers exactly where it needs to. So this is the final look. What do you guys think? Like, this is what I would wear if I wanted to get a little ready, but not too ready, but a little ready. You know. So yeah, this was my quick get ready with me. It was not quick. I took like 3 hours to do this because I'm talking so much. Let me know in the comments what your thoughts are. Let me know if you enjoy these kind of videos, and I will see you all really soon. Bye.